Dear students, let us try to understand the remaining portions of the lesson, The Earth, Our Living Planet. In our previous class, we already discussed about latitudes, longitudes, and important latitudes, and also the importance of latitudes and longitudes. Today we are going to discuss about longitude and time. Longitude and time. Yes, we studied what is longitude and what is latitude. Yes, before starting our class, we shall remember some points of our previous class. My question is now, important latitudes. Which are the important latitudes? According to this chapter, how many important latitudes are there? According to our textbook, there are 7 important latitudes. The first one is 0 degree, that is equator. Second one is 23.5 degree north latitude, that is also called Tropic of Cancer. That is in the northern hemisphere. In the same way, the southern hemisphere, 23.5 degree of latitudes are known as Tropic of Capricorn. Then 66.5 degree north latitude, that is Arctic Circle. And in the same way, 66.5 degree of latitudes in the southern hemisphere, that is Antarctic Circle. Then 90 degree, that is North Pole, and 90 degree in the southern hemisphere, that is Southern Pole. Thus, there are important latitudes, important 7 latitudes. Now, we are discussing about longitude and time. Longitude and time. What is the relation between longitude and time? There is a close relationship between longitude and time. According to the longitudes, we understand the time, international time, and also local time. Now the question is, how it is measured or how it is calculated? See students, yesterday in our previous class we studied there are 360 longitudes in the earth. All these longitudes are imaginary lines. Imaginary lines. Now, the longitude and time, there is a definite relationship between both longitude and time. The earth is, you know, the earth is rotating. It rotates on its own axis. This is axis, imagine. It rotates on its own axis from east to west or west to east. How? East to west or west to east. How? It rotates not east to west, it rotates west to east in this way. west to east. That is the rotation of the earth on its own axis. The earth is rotating on its axis and completes one rotation in 24 hours. The time limit is, or the time is to rotate east to west, the earth takes to complete one rotation. The earth takes 24 hours. 24 hours to cover full one round, to rotate fully, it takes 24 hours. This means 360 longitudes are covered in a period of 24 hours. 360 longitudes are there. It rotates its own axis to complete this 360 longitude. Earth takes how many hours? 24 hours, or it takes a day. It takes a day or 24 hours. This means 360 longitudes are covered in a period of 24 hours. 24 hours. This gives rise to a time difference of 4 minutes for every 1 degree of longitudes. Say, from while rotation from one longitude to another longitude, the time is 4 minutes. 4 minutes from longitude to longitude, it takes 4 minutes for every 1 degree of longitudes. So 60 minutes are 1 hour for every 15 degrees. 60 minutes or 1 hour for every 15 degrees. 1 to 1, it takes one longitude, it takes 4 minutes. To complete 60 degree, it takes 15 minutes. 60 minutes or 1 hour for every 15 degrees. Every 15 degrees, it takes 1 hour. 4 minutes for one longitude to another longitude. To complete 60 degrees of longitudes, it takes 1 hour. It takes 1 hour. 360 total number of longitudes. 4 minutes, one longitude to one longitude. The answer is 1440. Now it is divided by 60, 0, 0. Yes. Therefore, to complete one rotation, west to east, it takes, what is it? The earth takes 24 hours. Or 1 day, isn't it? 1 day, it has 24 hours. The time difference is to be added, EGA, east grain add, in case of places to the east of GMT, and in case of places to the west, in the time difference is to be subtracted. Say, while counting the times, Yes, this is Greenwich, the equator, North Pole to South Pole. This line, this is Western Hemisphere, this is Eastern Hemisphere. So, while if we start our journey from this point, Greenwich Meridian, to the east, you have to add some minutes to traveling the east side. In traveling east side, we have to add the time. If you travel to the west side, we have to subtract. What is a subtract means in mathematics, you know. What is a subtraction? You have to subtract while going to west. For east, you have to add the time. It is clear. After I will discuss about this. Therefore, on the basis of this calculation, 1 hour for each 15 degree, then total number of longitudes and 4 minutes answer divided by 60 or 1 hour, 60 minutes or 1 hour, 24 hours. Now it is possible to get local time or a country's time or international time. The first one is now local time. Local time. How can we identify local time through this longitude? Longitude and now it is time. Which time? That is local time. Yes. What is local time? Please look your textbook. The time according to the longitude of a place or according to the position of sun at that place is known as the local time. Here, 2 points are very important. First one is longitude, another one is sun. Yes, for example, take this Greenwich line. It is very important to know the local time of this place, or the place of sun is also very important. Students, listen here, this is the sun. Sun is overhead on this longitude. The sun's rays are falling vertically. Vertically means straightly on this longitude. If sun come to the center point of this line, the sun's rays are sunlight falls vertically. Vertically means lambavagi on this longitude. It is decided that when there is 12 o'clock or it is noon or 12 o'clock throughout this longitude. How many places are covering under this longitude? All these places have noon or 12 o'clock throughout this longitude. This is called local time of this area, not throughout the globe, not throughout the world. Suppose if west to east, come to this another longitude. If sun comes over head of this longitude, the same way here also the sun's vertical rays are falling on this longitude, then it is called noon or 12 o'clock. Therefore, throughout this longitude, what is the time? It is 12 o'clock. That is the local time. Next, another longitude. Now sun is overhead on this longitude. Now here sun rays falls vertically on throughout this longitude. Now it is called 12 o'clock or noon throughout the places. Therefore, local times are different from, or there is a little bit variation, fluctuations from longitude to longitude. Longitude to longitude. This is based on the local meridian passing over that place. What is the basis for this? That is the local meridian or local longitude passes on that place. When the sun is shining vertically over the longitude, it is 12 noon at that place. All places situated on the same meridian have the same local time. Every longitude has its own local time. Why? Because Earth is rotating on its own axis from west to east. Understood? Therefore, what is the clear, definite answer for local time? If sun rays falls vertically on any longitude, that is considered as the noon or 12 o'clock on the places of the same longitude. That is called local time. When throughout this places, throughout this longitude, the time is 12 o'clock. That is called the longitude and time, and it is called local time. For example, this one. See, now sun is overhead on this longitude. Now the places covering through this longitude have 12 o'clock. Therefore, it is considered as the local time throughout this longitude. That is called local time. Therefore, to know about local time, longitudes and sun rays. How it falls? Sun rays should fall vertically, straightly, then it is called noon. Then it is noon throughout that places. That places means the longitude passes some places, all the places has 12, places have 12 o'clock. That is called local time. Local time is that time is fixed only in that longitude. That is local time. Next, standard time. Another term is standard time. As the local time varies from place to place. Yes, local time difference from place to place. Why? Because of its rotation. It takes one longitude to another longitude, it takes 4 minutes. Therefore, each longitude has its own local time. It would create considerable confusion if each place were to follow its own local time. In order to avoid confusion, many countries follow uniform time throughout the country. Yes, for all these countries, how many continents? 7 continents. In each continent, the local time is different from other countries. Such a uniform time is based on the central meridian of the country or the meridian on which the most important city is located. The uniform time which is followed throughout a country is called standard time of that country. Students, now local time, yes, it is understood. Now the standard time, a particular time is very important for each and every country. It creates a little bit confusion, which creates longitude and local time or local time. It creates some confusion. Therefore, geographers thought that there should be a uniform time in a country or throughout the country. How it is measured or how we can find out this? See here, see, yes, what is this? Prime meridian. It passes through England, place called Greenwich. Greenwich. On the basis of this Greenwich line or meridian, throughout the country, we can decide a uniform system of time. Why it is Greenwich is base for this? Because in among the 7 continents, it is the middle part or the it is the middle meridian. Depending upon this, we can say that it is 12 o'clock or 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, etc. Therefore, this Greenwich is the center point for all the 7 continents. Then how we can measure the time, standard time for our India? There is a symbol. What is that symbol? The symbol is the line or the longitude which passes through the middle of a country is called that country's main meridian. Throughout the world, this is the center point, Greenwich. In India, that is, see here, observe this map. See the marked lines in green color. Greenwich is the center point of England. In India, that is Allahabad. Covering this Allahabad, 82 and half degree. It passes through Allahabad. Depending upon this, we can considered our standard time. Our standard time. That is called Indian Standard Time, IST. Students, we come to the conclusion that a longitude passes through a center point of a country. It is called the main meridian or main longitude of that country. It is considered as the standard time. throughout that longitude. For example, in India, 22.5 degree longitude passes through the main center of our country, that is none other than Allahabad. Allahabad, where here? 82.5. It passes through Allahabad. Depending upon this longitude or line, our Indian standard time is calculated. 82.5 degree, which east longitude, east longitude, 82.5 degree east longitude is considered as our base of Indian standard time. How it is possible? Answer is clear. Through this main meridian, only to India, throughout the world, that is Greenwich. In India, 82.5 degree east longitude. By this we can calculate our Indian standard time. Means, if sun is overhead of this line, it is considered as noon or 12 o'clock on the throughout this longitude. It is noon, it is midday. Because of this line, we can come to the conclusion that Indian standard time is calculated on the basis of this 82.5 east longitude. Next, only two concepts, time zones and international dateline, we shall discuss in our next class. Sai Ram.